All right, welcome to another episode of the Bradford City Career Mode. As always, now this is the usual series that goes up on the channel daily. If you're not used to it by now, then I'm very, very shocked. I think it's like a 63rd video now. I apologise for it being so late. I've been busy today. I had driving lessons and stuff to do. My sister's birthday. We went out for dinner, so this is gonna be up pretty late. I don't know if it'll be up before midnight, but I'm hoping it will be. Hopefully, I can get up before then. But I apologise if it isn't. I will put a thing in the description as well. But yeah, I apologise that it's late. But anyway, last game we were against Bury, I believe, in the Carabao Cup, and we buried Bury, which is the whole point of the last video's title, I guess. I've had a few ciders as well, so if I sound a bit sluggish, then that'd be why. But we're gonna go back to the main team here. I've made two little lineups now, because it's kind of getting annoying having to switch players all the time, and I probably should have done this earlier, but I've switched lineups about now. We've got the main lineup, which is probably what I'm going to do with this. I've swapped Hloszczyk and Greenwood around just for sort of a test period. That's not going to be a definite change. And also, I'm bringing Henley back in at right back. Must not be a definite change, like I said. And then we've got some players here that might switch in. Obviously, this male will come rotate back in for either Roberts or McCartan once he comes back to full fitness. So I've got two team sheets now. And also, I should update you guys, if you didn't see last time, we've been continuing with the Youth Academy. We set up a youth squad, or youth scout, I should say, in Russia for 3 months. We should get, I think we get reports from him every 11th of the month, because that's when we sent him out. But also, I should update you on how we're doing in the league. We've had two games, we've got two wins so far, not exactly convincing wins. In either of them, maybe Barnsley 1-0, I believe we beat Lincoln 2-1. So I'm hoping for a convincing win to show that we are truly wanting to go for promotion. I'm going to the news quickly just to keep up to date. Play the competition for what? Oh, the Super Cup. It's literally one match. I don't know how you have a player of the tournament for that. It's Immobile from Lazio, but I don't know how you get that. And obviously we've got our own news. I should probably just read these instead of the world news. So Scannell is on the transfer list. Doyle is on the transfer list. Well, Mari Patrick's on the transfer list. French is on the transfer list. It's just basically updating. Everyone is on the transfer list. Brady and Russo have been added to loan list because Russo is young. Brady's also young. And I feel like Brady would benefit from a year of loan action and then maybe coming back in, replacing Akpan as a backup, or even replacing Beaton as a starting midfielder. I don't know. But anyway, that's the squad we're going to use. That's going to be our main squad, I think. I know I already said that, except it's not going to be our main squad. I don't know why Ross is in there. We need to put a grill back in there. But apparently, besides that, I think that's our main squad. I don't know what I'm trying to say apparently for, but yeah, that's going to be our main starting 11. Hopefully, we can add to that in January. I'm really hoping for some pre-contract signings. I'm really hoping for some big youth academy spots, especially as soon as we've got that 4-star, 5-star scout. He should be a big bonus. He's taken pretty much all our budget to send him out, but I'm really hoping we can get a couple of bits of money from players I want to sell as well. So hopefully we have enough to sign a player on pre-contract. It doesn't have to be a massive player, it just has to be a player that'll impact the team in some sort of way. But anyway, we're going to go into the game against Wycombe here. We are away from home. We've got Leonard Grill in goal. We've got Kakachi and Henley as the fullbacks. Worrell is the captain, of course, and Hennessy alongside him in centre-back. I put Worrell as a captain, by the way, just to keep people up to speed because he has a leadership trait. I thought I might as well, otherwise his morale going down. Carbonero and Greenwood as the wide midfielders. Beaton in the centre. Robertson McCartan as a centre attacking midfielders. And we're going to try Hloszczyk up front. See if it makes any difference having Greenwood up front. We'll give it a go anyway. If it doesn't work, we can always rotate it back. But I want Greenwood in the squad. I want Greenwood to improve. I don't have to drop him to the bench just because he's not playing well. In the Bury game, I don't know if you've watched the episode or not, so I'm going to spoil it for you here. But in the Bury game, he hit the post twice, I believe, and he had so many good chances, and their goalkeeper... To be fair, their goalkeeper didn't... Although we deserve to score more than four, their goalkeeper did put some good saves. I'll give their goalkeeper credit for that. Who's this with? Is this with Carbonero? It'd be better if this was with a striker, to be honest, rather than with a midfielder. Are you kidding me? Than with a midfielder. But, whatever. Skill games aren't what we're here for. But yeah, I'm recording this very late. Really, we're on about 20 to 11. I apologise for that. I've been out with family. My sister's birthday, so kind of like a birthday meal. And a couple of drinks as well, so... Like I said, hopefully I'm going to get this up before midnight, but if I don't, I apologise in advance. Obviously, normal service will resume tomorrow. Should be up around 8 o'clock. I'm going to try to aim for about 8 p.m. for the uploads. And then for the double uploads, about 8 and half 8, sort of thing. Or 8 and then 9, maybe, within that time frame. I want to try and get some sort of, like... I know I have a rhythm to it already, like the daily videos, but I want to try and get it as in like a certain time going up around 8 o'clock-ish, between 8 p.m. and 9 p.m. I feel like it's a decent time, because then like people are going to bed or people are just chilling. It's a decent time for people to watch videos, I guess. But anyway, we've got Wycombe's lineup here. They don't have Akinfenwa. I checked that last episode. He retired, but they do still have a strong squad. They're only playing 4 at the back, which is a bonus, because I hate playing against 5 at the back defences. I was half considering bringing in some wing backs myself, but I've kept it at 4 at the back. And as you can see, we've got the boys here. And a couple of people on the bench in case the main players get tired as well. I rested the main team midweek because we had a game against Bury that I was pretty confident in winning. I know it's only Carabao Cup, which doesn't mean a lot, but I suppose in League One it means a bit more because you want to try and get some silverware under your belt. But like I said, I put out the second team for that, and most of the main team are full fitness. Greenwood, obviously, a little bit off full fitness because he played in that game against Bury. So a couple of them will be off full fitness, but most of them will be full fitness and ready to go for league action. Hopefully we can get our third win in a row. And the Wycombe are going to kick off here. Oh, okay, they're going to turn both my players there. And Henley's already out of position, which is an issue. Sorry, right, Grill collects. Throwing out to nobody in particular, apparently. Okay, this is not good. Not a good start. Good block from Hennessy. Waiting for a rebound. Henley blocks and brings it clear. Not the best start here. Sorry if I sound a little bit pissed. I've had a couple of sides, like I said. Blaszczyk. Oh, I was really hoping to... Bradford player was making a run through there, but Bradford player is making a run through. It's Carbonero, and why is that on? Hold on. Is that the trainer that switched? Why is that on? No, hide that. Why is it even on? I don't even remember turning that on. Carbonero's put it wide anyway. It was probably either way. It probably would have gone wide, but I'm not sure why that switched itself on. To be honest. Lose the possession there, but we had a chance there with Carbonero, it just wasn't to be. Speaking of Carbonero, interception by him, Beaton now. Run through. Oh my days, he's run through way too fast there. And by way too fast, I mean I played the pass earlier, but the game decided to have Beaton take an extra touch. Wycombe plays this smooth football here. Like I said, I don't know who the actual rivals for promotion are, because I thought Lincoln were going to be pretty difficult and we beat them. Although, to be fair, they did play well. Just under 10 minutes in, and there's not been much to show from either team. We've had chances, but we haven't had a goal yet, which at 10 minutes in, it's not really the end of the world. Worrell now receiving the possession. Down to Kakache. Beaton. Signed him on a pre-contract from Celtic last season. It's a smart move as well. Be a very good holding midfielder. Greenwood has been fouled there. It's on the edge of the area. Freeman's going to get a yellow, I believe, here. I was really hoping... Well, I wasn't really hoping. I was possibly hoping I could get in the box and then give it away. It'd be a penalty. Slightly easier opportunity for us. But it's going to be a free kick on the edge of the area. Not as smart as the tackles, really, was it? Greenwood making a run for once in his pathetic life. Anyway, on the edge of the area, we just need to try and find a man here. Just knock it in for us, make it 1-0. It looks like McCartan's going to be the one to knock it in. But I don't know who really to aim for here. Obviously, there's multiple options. There's Carbonero, Blaszczyk, Beaton... and Roberts. And it's gone straight to Beaton, I believe, and it's just over. I don't know what's going on with his head. Perfect cross, but it's a bit too much power on the header, unfortunately, for near Beaton there. Coming his first goal in the Bradford City shirt. Just over the top here at the Wycombe ground. I'm not going to pretend another stadium name because I have a clue. Receive the ball from their goal kick, which is good. Beaton, Carbonero, Roberts in the middle, perhaps. Yeah, Beaton. Oh, I was hoping McCartan would make a better run there, or maybe Greenwood would have made a run, but not to be. He can make it a run. Vargas making a run, but Roberts is tracked all the way back. You'll have to see it from Patrick Roberts. That's not. No. Not what I was doing at all. I don't know what the game thinks I'm doing there, but that wasn't it. That was not it, Chief. If that had gone in, I would have been a little bit mad. I don't know what the fuck Grill was thinking. Obviously, I've only got myself to blame for that, but I thought it might be a nice little pass to the defender that I want to make. No. Passed it way too far. Beaton loses possession. They go over the top. I believe Henley should get there, and he will. Greenwood. McCartan has got the pace, but in League One, it takes a little bit more than pace. Ah, Hloszczyk loses out. Like I said, Hloszczyk as striker is only a trial sort of thing. It's not like we're going to keep him there. It's like, are we going to keep him there? Passes in, but Grill has it covered. I believe it's going to go for a goal kick. A big transfer for Naby Keita. And we're going to obviously go over the transfers on transfer deadline day. All the big moves, all sorts, I guess. I usually just keep it above 30 million and then read that, like, go from the top and then read till I get to 30 million, which is what I will do. It won't change. I just want to see what other clubs are doing compared to us in the market, more or less. Greenwood, Beaton. I should give credit to Hloszczyk, actually. He won his possession back, and then we lost it again. Not where I even directed the header, but.
Okay.
Interception by accident, but it's worked. I didn't take a heavy touch there, but okay. That's fine.
Teammates could potentially join in.
They keep Worrell at the back just in case. And it doesn't really make a difference because Grill couldn't save his own fucking life. 1-0 to Wycombe.
Things have got to change on both sides.
I can't even put blame up for that. Except for my goalkeeper, who could have done better with the save, realistically. I was going to close him down with Worrell, who decided to go a different direction. And Grill should be saving that. It was a pretty decent low shot, but Grill should be able to tip that around the post, realistically. Stretch out a bit further and that should be a save, but.
Well, the manager's showing signs of frustration. They need to improve if they're going to get something out of this game, Derek.
What can you do? Alex Samuel puts Wycombe a goal up. And the harsh lesson I'm going to learn this season is you can't win them all. And I think I've realised that. But we can bring this back. Plenty of time to go. The players actually want to move, that'd be useful. Roberts. Like my left back perhaps. Catchy, want to make a run. Something perhaps. Just crazy idea. Kind of out there, but possibility. McCartan. Let's just chuck the pass down. I'm going to have one of those episodes, I think. Especially when my guys want to change player as well. But it doesn't really matter because they just kicked off the pitch for no reason.
Alan McAnally with his finger on the pulse.
Kikachi.
It's with Joe Worrell.
Worrell, a bit of a weird first touch there, but it's worked out. Hennessy onto McCartan.
Greenwood.
He's made it past the defender. It
looks promising. He could pick out a teammate.
Well, he could pick out a teammate if said teammate actually worked to hold his run, but I guess not.
Cutting infield here.
Oh, come on. I'm trying to build an attack here and they just know every time where the pass is going to go. Beaton should win the header and he does. Carbonero.
Dangerous looking attack.
Poshek is tackled. Right. Fuck off, cunt.
The hosts really haven't had too much of the ball, but on the break they've been.
As I say, yeah, we've had a lot of possession, we just haven't really been able to build anything from that.
They've been electric when they've had the ball.
And they seem to just beat my player to every ball, despite the fact that I'm just fully putting my effort to stop it.
And moving the ball nicely.
Bring it away at least anyway. Maybe I shouldn't be passing out defence every time, but I am doing. It's kind of how I do things, so maybe I should. It's some new tactics, I suppose. Okay, so McCartan has like 90 pace, but can't get past the defender. Greenwood's about 75, 80, and he can get past the problem. Offside again for Wycombe.
42 minutes played, 1-1. Thank you, Alan McAnally.
Honestly, I can't be bothered recording, but I need to get a video out today because I haven't done one yet. That's not where I fucking pass. Can this game please get some directional help? I'm not passing it in that direction at all whatsoever.
Freeman and options in the center.
And it just goes there. Worrell should be getting that, he's not, and it's just past the post. I believe it was Samuel again. Worrell's out of position. Kakachi decides not to header it. It was almost 2-0 to the home team. And the Wycombe crowd chatting, you're not singing anymore, and we're not. Are you kidding me? I'm pressing LB for days there just to try and get Beaton on it, and the game just doesn't register. What's the fucking point in having a change player option when it doesn't physically let you change player? Ennis was a good tackle, but it's not going to make a difference because I think it's half time before we can get another attack. Again. Oh, never mind. It's Beaton running through. I mean, no disrespect to Beaton. He's a good midfielder and all, but he's just not the person you want running through there. Half time now, and it's 1-0 down for us, I guess. Samuel gets a goal when my goalkeeper should have saved it. Obviously, I should have done better with defending. I'm not putting it all on the grill, but. A tip to the side of the post would not have got a miss there, and it would have been an easy save to make. Anyway, we'll take a look at the stats. I feel like the stats will probably be in their favour, but I don't know if that really reflects how the game's been going. I've been making chances, just haven't got the shots off. Oh, I have got the shots off and just not put them on target. That works too. Anyway, we're just going to head in. We've had more possession. Shot accuracy is nil for us, so that's not... And now the promising. Second half is underway. He just knows. He's aware. He knows exactly what I'm going to do, and he's ready for it.
Freeman.
And then my right back can't keep up with their left mid, so...
Now can he deliver accurately?
Never mind. Can Henley with a very good tackle there. To close down Freeman. Oh, come on, McCartan. Are you fucking kidding me? So obviously you got League 2 player in a League 1 team.
46 minutes played. 2-1. Many thanks, Alan. Crossing into the middle.
Cross is far. Too far. Might go out of play. Samuel's kept it in. And Henley just takes him down with a tackle. Corner though to Wycombe. I was like a tackle out for a throw in instead, but not to be. Corner now, Varg is on it. Should be header away, realistically, but it's not going to be. That'd be the easy option of sorting things out in defence. Good catch by Grill, and maybe a quick break here is what's needed. Not where I love it. I love this game. It's actually really, really good. I'm fully passing it to the left wing. And yeah, it's a foul. Yeah, it's a foul. Cool. I'm honestly not in the mood for this game. I just want to go to bed, but I need to get a video out to this. So.
Well, definitely a yellow card, Derek.
Worrell picks up a booking, and they're going to get a free kick. I mean, it wasn't exactly the cleanest of tackles, but I don't know. Freeman coming off for Anya Dinma. Free kick now. Jacobson standing over it. given it a try, to be fair to him, but it's not gone well.
Well, I'm hearing there's been a
goal. Oh, can the pass just work, please? I know I'm expecting a lot there, but honestly, we're in League One, we should be passing a bit better now. Fucking can't be arsed. Look at these fucking... Are you kidding me? They're pulling off trick passes and fucking everything, and I can't do shit. Gapes put it wide for Wycombe. I don't know how Greenwood's exhausted. He hasn't contributed a thing to this match. He's had one run, probably, with a cross, although, to be fair, he did win a free kick as well, I guess. That's literally all he's contributed. Greenwood heads it, to be fair.
Look at those stats, Derek.
Keep the ball. Just keep the ball. All you need to do is have possession. It's not difficult. You just don't lose the ball. So Henley heads it straight to their player. Yeah, okay. That's about right. Yep. Minor block. Anyway, cool. Yeah. I think it's damage limitation at this point. I haven't done anything threatening to get an equaliser, so... Worrell gets his foot in the way and it's a corner. I'm fucking completely ready to go to bed straight after this video. Obviously I'm going to upload it first and then ready to go to bed. Is it so difficult to clear the ball? I mean, a bit of power behind the header perhaps. I know it's a bit crazy, but maybe if I just try and clear it, it might get clear, but I guess not. And they go 2-0 up. I'm not expecting to win every game this season, but all I want is for my defenders to actually clear the ball with some sort of fucking distance, I guess. Gapes had the shot here. It should be blocked by perhaps one of my defenders. I'm not going to blame Grill for that one, because my defenders should have had that blocked and closed down, but they didn't. And they're now 2-0 up.
When you sit off like this, you invite pressure.
I'll try to set off like anything. I'm trying to make attacks, but my main players that need to be involved in said attacks don't make any fucking attempt to do anything.
Bitton.
Kakachi, Carbonero. I'm going to get closed down. I've got no options either, so I have to give up the ball here, because I can't fucking do shit, because this game is fucking shit and my players don't attack.
Thompson.
It's beautiful.
Well, let's get details of,
of course, I get lucky bounce and it just goes straight back to them. Whenever they get a lucky bounce, though, note this, and maybe in future episodes, maybe in past episodes you've seen it, whenever they get a lucky bounce, it goes straight to their player. The LB in this game, I might as well just fucking rip off my left bumper off my controller and not use it. Because I've tried to switch player for days and it just doesn't register. And they get a shot out of nowhere there. A very good save from Grill, to be fair. I'm not going to understate that. Substitutions in both teams here, because I'm bringing off Beaton.
Well, they've been getting the substitute ready, and now they will make the personnel change.
I honestly just want to go to sleep. Corner from Wheeler. Hate corners on this game because I hate headers on this game. You can't header it a fucking way to try and clear it.
Space and time for the cross.
Worrell heads it to Anderson. McCartan.
Kloszek.
Of course, I'm going to get shut down because once again I have no options. Apparently, my guy's the slowest in the planet. Henley's 3 miles out of position. I'm not even mad at the game, I just can't be bothered, to be honest, but I need to get a video out. So here you go, this is what you get. when I'm absolutely exhausted and I just want to go to bed, but I need to do daily videos.
No real threat, you've got to say.
I should have done it earlier, but I was busy earlier, so... offside, mate. Just let the game go, actually. Never mind. Stop. Call it from side. What the fuck? Anything I do just gets shut down. Nice save though, I suppose. It's not too bad. But it also means another corner, which I'm not going to be able to clear because my players don't have clear corners. Yeah, roll it when all the Wycombe players are there. Yeah, roll that ball. And it closed down here unless I get an option. I don't know. I have to run all the way with Carbonero onto the other wing. It's another foul. Bad challenge, and now it's up to the referee in terms of what to do next. Carbonero ran so far there, he's getting no support.
He's got to go into the book. Yeah, he's mistimed more than anything there, just mistimed his tackle.
Did that out of desperation, really. There's nobody in the box, I don't know why he bothered. I might take this with a left foot guy so I could swing it a bit more. I just wanted to go to someone's head and into the back of the net. I'm going to 10 minutes off the end though, so the sooner I get it done, so I can go to bed. Aim in the middle somewhere, I suppose.
Into the box it goes.
Of course, it's straight cleared by the first fucking defender. Why wouldn't it be?
And the cross is very much on.
And everyone's back, so I don't know what I'm going to do here. But Holoshek takes a shot. It's closed down, obviously, because everyone's back. Amid impending danger.
It has gone over the touchline for what will be a throw-in.
See.
It's the second goal for Fleetwood Town. 7 minutes remain. 2-2. Thanks, Alan. A tremendous vision.
Henley, I don't know, it's a crazy idea, but would you like to get back into where you're actually meant to be playing? Yeah, if he punches that, I'd fucking sell him, honestly. Doesn't go to the player I aim for, maybe not to the left wing, goes down the middle. Okay. Take notes, ladies and gentlemen.
He's going forward well here. And Wheeler, and a good looking ball.
Just in the middle. I want a header of that, but I guess I'll use my foot. Works. Greenwood making a run for once in his pathetic life. Now he's got no stamina left. Boschek's the only option, but of course that gets closed down because I know exactly where I'm going to pass it because it's the only option. Maybe a fucking video full of complaints. So I just want to go to bed. Cross it, one. That's an easy catch, please. That was down the middle, but that wasn't to Hloszek. It was meant to be to the fucking middle cunt. Carbonero. I don't want to, like, offend him by getting his name wrong. I'm starting to think Greenwood's a waste of money, to be completely honest.
In the grand scheme of things, he's going to be terribly proud of that headed attempt. Well, heading practice in training next week, that was pretty...
It's high and wide, but it doesn't matter because they're 2-0 up. I could have probably had a break and missed out a day, but I don't really want to miss out a day.
1 minute remaining.
So instead we're going to get a lackluster performance where my players are out of position and their players are just doing the perfect passes. I'm just going to hold the ball. I cannot be arsed with any more action in this game. You already won 2-0. I don't know what you want from me. Third goal.
And the referee's whistle. That is the end of the story.
Obviously, Hloszek doesn't work very well up front because we barely had any shots on goal. Two goals which could have easily been defended were not defended, and that's what's given them the 2-0 win here. They dominated. They actually got more possession as well. I couldn't get a shot on target because apparently they had the best defenders in the league. Obviously, Hloszek is not a good player up front. He's better as a wide midfielder. Greenwood got a 7, despite I don't think doing much at all. Henley and Grill were our best players, and that says something when Grill wasn't that good at all. Hloszek with a 6.1. Nervous player goes to Gape with an 8.8. The batting defense an 8.2 as well. Everyone got decent rings for them, I guess.
We've got some questions for you.
36, it was a tough match. Where do you think it went wrong today? Everywhere. I'll take blame. I think we started a little sluggishly and never really got into the game. Obviously, as a manager, I take full responsibility for that. Especially because I'm tired. Bradford City did not manage to score today and ended up losing the game. What went wrong? It's always what went wrong for every single question. They need to freshen up the questions. They were the better team. Scotland says it all. Wycombe Wanderers were the better team. We have to prepare better for our next game. Gabe was one of the best players of the opposition today. Is your inability to stop him the reason behind your failure to gain a positive result against Wycombe? I prefer to concentrate on what we can do better. There are areas of our game that need work, no question about it. Like, why does my goalkeeper have a good game one week and then play like a fucking idiot the next? That's what I'm wondering. He does so well and then decides to do absolute garbage. We dropped down to mid-table without loss anyway, but we still got 2 wins out of 3, which isn't too bad. Greenwood's really getting on my nerves. He's not performing like I expected him to, but I suppose he's not been here long, but he's still annoying. I was hoping maybe to have a goal in the actual season. I know he had a goal to pre-season, but I was hoping to have more of an impact, really, than what he's had. I suppose better train Grill a little bit, or bloody Rossi will catch up. Oh, I completely forgot about Conte. Conte, actually. Not Conte. Rossi goes up 72, now both my goalkeepers 72 rated, they'll be asking for starting spots. Greenwood almost 70. Grill 72, Courtney almost 63. Decent results. As well, sim up to the next game. Thanks for the Sparks, Miller. Any transfer offers before we get to Burton Albion? Doesn't look like it. Oh, we have got a loan offer for Brady. For those unknown, they have shown interest in taking Darren Brady on a 1-year deal. You can find the details in your folder. Alright. He's one of the guys I wanted to get a loan for, just to give him some more experience. It's not like his wage is a lot anyway, so we could split that quite easily. 450 weekly wage. Obviously, he'll probably want more wage when he comes back, which I can accept. Could swap Loshik and Greenwood back around, because Loshik doesn't work in striker. What's his pace? 75. Greenwood's is 77. McCartan's is 90, but Greenwood can get past defenders and McCartan can't. Beaton's pretty slow. Carbonero's quite fast now. Roberts is eh. Catches, he's getting there. Worrell, I expect to be slow. Hennessy's okay for a defender. Henley's alright. But it's all about, like, it's not just like sprint speed, it's like acceleration as well. His acceleration is better than the sprint speed. Kloschik's is almost the same. McCartan's is really good. McCartan, I'm hoping McCartan can actually do more, but at the moment he hasn't started off with a great season, which sucks, to be honest. But that's where we're going to leave it for this episode. Up next, obviously, we've got Burton. They've not had the best of starts. I'm trying to see where they are in the league. Oh, rock bottom. If we lose to Burton, or if we don't get a win against Burton, I'm going to be really upset. Hopefully tomorrow I won't be as tired and get a decent result. Only four teams with a perfect season so far. Charlton, Peterborough, Blackpool and Ipswich. And then unbeaten on top of that are Wycombe and Rochdale. We're down 11th now mid-table. But that's going to end another episode. Thank you, 5,000 more Sparks, Miller. It's going to end another episode, like I said, of the Bradford City Career Mode. Back tomorrow against Burton. And I'm pretty sure we're getting close to transfer deadline day now. I'm hoping a couple more. What the fuck? I would say we've got Premier League opposition, but we don't anymore because they got relegated. You've got Sheffield United in the second round of the Carabao Cup. I just took a look there, and obviously pretty big opposition. I don't know if we'll beat them, but anyway, we'll give it a try eventually. But next time we'll be Burton. I hope you guys have enjoyed another episode of the Bradford City Career Mode. I'm sorry it's a disappointing result, but I'm almost about to fall asleep. Hope you guys have enjoyed. I'll see you next time.